Yes? Sure.
You won't be able to get that computer to lower the energy fields unless you know the proper codes. Lucky for you, I've got them. I picked them off the pocket of a black bulker who had a little too much to drink in the cantina one night. Here, let me get that energy field down for you.
What? Yes?
gotta do something about your breath. I didn't want to say anything, but it's bad. In fact, now that I think about it, your breath has been pretty rancid ever since we rescued you from those Gamorrean slavers. Oh, Zalbar, that's terrible. I know how grouchy you get if you don't get your 8 square meals a day. I'm amazed you didn't pass out from hunger. Ew! No wonder your breath is so bad, Big Z. Gamorreans smell like bantha poodoo. We'll have to pick you up a toothbrush to clean that stench out of your choppers. Okay, relax. No toothbrush. Sheesh. Just try and eat something else to cover up.
Here! Oopsies.
Please don't hurt me. I just serve the food here, that's all. I'm not like these others. I'm not even a Black Vulker. Please don't kill me. My name is Ada. My father owed Davik some money, but he couldn't pay. Davik killed my father and sold me into slavery here at the Vulker compound to pay off the debt. No!
Watawa mamulira, King Kuntwa Peshak, Nova Muliraji, Johnny Yuturu, Tonga Bogsham Uninong, Wanga Kun Pistkin, Vamulira. Juni yutakum justak miki grabel mogo. Kachi chu aitha haudunga. Tulpa da bonk mwalyak. Kachi chu aitha haudunga. In kinku no ba muli rachi. Takum justak miki grabel mogo. Kachi chu aitha haudunga. Tulpa da bonk mwalyak ando danago. Tung hai tuam jiji yumalit pa ang ninkotu. Tulpa da Kachi chu aitha haudunga. In kinku no ba... Chibedwana ni bobo. Kuya mi juz kachita naipatoga ya fulki kukula jiji. Kawata bistyubon konki pangpa. Chingpala chiska muli. Tuni rana. Konti chani. Mulira ashong turung unni patoga wanka. Achuta.
Yes?
What?
Sure.
Yeah?
Sure.
What?
What? Thank you.
Hey, Big Z, don't take this the wrong way, but lately, I've not... No, I'm not suggesting a bath. I know how well that went over last time. But your hair's getting all tangled, and if you look close, you can see... Don't worry, Big Z. It's nothing I can't fix. A little trim, a splash of coloring, and you'll be as good as new. Best looking Wookiee on the planet. Maybe a nice suit. I know, Wookiees aren't into the whole clothing thing, but you could start a whole new trend. You'd be on... Okay, okay, sheesh. Try to offer some constructive criticism, and this is the thanks I get? Let's move on. You can just stay naked and scruffy for all I care. Thank you.
ями джуз качита, найпатогая фульки, кукуля джити. Кауана бота, а ают так.
Брешик stole that engine from Gadden. It was never yours to begin with.
Каватумпа кунпа ия мокапата.
Уана чек йонги? Уана бота кунтитари ти?
Качи чу айза одунга. Ин кин куно бамули рачи кун. Слима пот. Тонга бугшам унинон. Уанга кун бисткин бамулира. Чуни.
What? You can't betray Gadden. I won't let you.
Чашонг погра хулван чиска ничу. Ачуба чиска ванки. Ти токи град.
No, that's not true. You're lying.
Мана мана тота. Аку чикра тук пола. Чишок чонатон чонкин но уна панк памулира кун кили.
They said I was too young.
Шаг джикин лор чауа та ума. Кава вулпа мульджи гумана.
Well, yeah, some of them were, but you Volkers have tried to kill me more than once.
Таком джус так мики грабл мого. Качи чу айта одонга, тулпа да бонг молья гандо да наг.
But Gadden said Брежик...
Кипуна! Буна не качу. Кимба но мулина на дуана. Тун кимба но куннек. Кава...
You're right. I don't need anyone but Zalbar. If Gadden dies, he's only getting what's coming to him.
Тонгай туам джиджи юма литпа анг инкоту. Толба да бунг валья гандо да наго чучут. Качи чуай са хаудонга. Юма рунди хаудонга кухунга би. Вана кунбес. Чинг пала мул тонг кимба на конгек. Тунг тинг та чун кун нек мули рабест. Та бист юбон конки панкпа. Чинг пала чиска мули. Туни рана но брата дунк но сърча дома уама кун без дома. Шак джи лоджа кин кун оба мули раджи кун. Куя ми джуз качита, найпатога я фулки кукуля джи джи. Кауана бота, а ают тагуа. Канки дора ти кун муатта ти мана изабула. Мана мана тота. Аку чикра тук пола. Чишок чонатон чонкин но уна панкпа мулира кун кили. Кун кили конти чани. Мулира шонг турун умнит патога уанка чоне тизе. Кипуна! Буна не качу. Кимба но мулина на дуана. Тун кимба но...
Gadden can't speak to you right now. Brezhik's put a price on his head, so I ordered him to stay in his Yes, good. The more people who keep an eye out, the better we'll catch this.
Wamiji yumalit ba ak inkoton jino. Bapun konin ka. Bapun konin. Tati.
Sure.
Yeah?
What? What?
Thank you. are you? You can't come in here. Sound the alarm, Gaddon.
Relax, Kira. This is an ally, not an enemy. He's promised to help get our prototype accelerator back from the Vulkers.
You're too trusting, Gaddon. These must be the assassins Brezhik sent. How else did they get in here? Liar. The guards would have announced you. Gaddon, we've been betrayed again. We're under attack. Guards! Guards!
Just fire!
What?
Huh?
Yes?
I'm a piece of shit.
What?
What?
Hey there, what can I do for you?
Really? You want to know about me? Nobody's ever really been interested in me before. What do you want to know? Big Z's my family, you know? My parents, well, I guess they're dead. It was just me on my own until the day I saw Zalbar in the lower city. I could tell right away he was in trouble. This was before the gang wars were out of hand. But even then, the Volkers were scum. A few of them were hassling Big Z, trying to pick a fight, but he wasn't looking for trouble. Hey, nobody said the Volkers were smart, but there were three of them. So maybe they figured they could handle him. I don't know. Anyway, I don't like the Volkers at the best of times. And when I saw them picking on this poor Wookiee, all alone on a strange planet, overwhelmed by the big city, I just lost it. I screamed out, "Leave him alone, you core slimes!" and charged right at them. Well, one of them saw me coming and slapped me so hard he just about knocked me cold. Those Volkers didn't scare me. They're nothing but cowards. I knew how to deal with them. Of course, I never got the chance. I guess Zalbar didn't like seeing me get smacked around. He let out this howl and yanked that Volker a meter up off the ground and held him there by his throat. Are you kidding? Big Z ain't like that. He's just a big old softy inside. Of course, the Volkers didn't know that. The other two screamed and ran off. Can't say I blame them. The first time you see an angry Wookiee up close, it isn't a pretty sight. I thought Zalbar was gonna rip that punk's arms off and beat him to death with his own fists. The Volker was so scared, he fainted. Or maybe it was Big Z's breath just knocked him out. Sorry, Zalbar, but I keep telling you to brush those choppers once in a while. Why do you think I won't stand downwind when you're talking? Anyway, I knew those Volkers would be back with friends, so I grabbed Zalbar and we took off. Ever since... He was fleeing some kind of trouble back on Kashyyyk. That's all I know, really. Big Z doesn't like to talk about it. In case he didn't notice, he's the strong, silent type. Doesn't much matter to me, though. I accept him for what he is, not what he was. Me and Zalbar like to live in the present. Hey, what's that supposed to mean? You think I can't take care of myself? I've got In fact, I look out for Zalbar more than he looks out for me, you know? Big Z's a little bit too gullible to make it alone on the mean streets of the lower city. Yeah, I suppose you're right. Like I used to tell my brother, fast talk and slick words don't get the job done. My brother's a touchy subject, you know? It just so happens, I don't really feel like talking about him right now. Nothing personal. Let's just get back to the business at hand, okay?
Greetings once more, Upworld. It is as I feared, then. She joins the list of those who have given their lives in the service of our cause. But though I am saddened by this news, there is yet hope. By finding my apprentice, you have proved yourself worthy, Upworlder. You are to be the beacon on our path to salvation. You are marked, Upworlder. Even my dim old eyes can see the mantle of destiny that... I am old. I have lived 100 years in the Undercity, cast down into the dark. I offer you wisdom, and you turn me away? Perhaps you... Very well, Upworlder.
Welcome back, Up. Why have you come...
Ooh, look at my eyes. I gotta run all the way back to the bad guys I just sided with.
Esta bistiu von konkipangpa. Chingpala chiska muli. Tuni rana no brata. Kavatumpa kunpa yiya mokapata. Bonan night kachu. Yin kin kuno kuya mi juz kachita. Naipatoga ya fulki. Kukule tong hai tuam jiji yumalith pa ang ninkotu. Tolba da bunk walya gando de nago takum justak miki grabel mogo. Kachi chu ai thao donga. Tolba da bunk walya gando da nago chuchut. Shag jikin lor chawa ta uma? Kava vulpa mulji gumana. Kin kun shachi tonga bug sham uninong? Wanga kun beast king ba mulira. Chuni yun tun. Shag jikin lor chawa ta uma? Kava vulpa mulji gumana. King kun shachi king, ni king kun oba tonga bug sham uninong? Wanga kun bi konti chani, mulira shong turung umnit patoga wanka chone tize.
Chopa chawi ti chok twiz yun kun atu yama kama shagji kina lorcha watamwana
takum justak miki grabel moko kachichu ita botunga tolo kuyami justu na jitanai ina chawara bota ayu ata honga chakanki dora kachiku ita hodonga topa da bunk walya gando do nano chuchut Musha papa, tiska do suki kuba na bona na gachu, abdu inkotu. Topa da bunkwa liagando na do chuchut. Kabat. Kuyami chuskuna chitanai. Inakun mama rulira rachikun. Slimo patona. Jawana bota ayu at tahunga chakanki dora. Kachiku ita hodonga. Topa da bunkwa liagando do na do chuchut. Musha papa, kuyami chuskuna chitanai. Ina kun mama ruli ra ra chikun slimo patona mundi hodonga chikon kabi ubabatu kochi.
It's pod racing time. I use a space bar. Okay, now I got it. I still beat the time. I know how to do it now, bitch. Beating that. Call me Anakin.
I, Brezhik, leader of the Black Vulkus, am honored to award the victory prize to one of my own, once again proving the Vulkus are the premier gang of Taris. Well done. Through your skill and courage, you have proven yourself the premier swoop rider and brought great glory to the Black Vulkus. That's why it is with the greatest sadness that I have to inform you of a slight change in the prize I am offering for your victory. When you hear what I have to say, you'll understand. It seems the woman I offered up as a prize is more than just a Republic officer. She's actually a Jedi. I've had to equip her with a neural disruptor collar to keep her mind in a state of unfocused confusion, just to make sure she doesn't use her force powers to escape. Obviously, I can't turn her over to you. It would be far too dangerous to have a Jedi as a slave. But rest assured, I'll find some other way to compensate you for your victory.
Yeah.
You old fool. Your traditions are nothing to me. I am the wave of the future. If I want to withdraw the prize and sell this woman on the slave market myself, nobody can stop me.
I might have something to say about that, Brezhik.
Oh, baby.
What? Impossible. You were restrained by a neural disruptor. How could you have possibly summoned the will to free yourself?
You underestimate the strength of a Jedi's mind, Brezhik. A mistake you won't live to regret.
Vulkus, to me! Kill this woman! Kill the swoop rider! Kill them all!
Get that shit off me. This guy's tough. Die already. Thank you.
those bloody Vulkas will think twice next time before trying to keep a Jedi prisoner. And as for you, if you think you can collect me as a prize... I don't believe this. You're one of the soldiers with the Republic fleet, aren't you? Yes, I'm sure of it. How did you end up racing for these swoop gangs?
I own you now.
You must have banked a turn too sharply, because it sounds like all the blood has rushed from your brain. I am Bastila Shan, a member of the Jedi Order and a fleet commander for the Republic. Nobody owns me. Now, we don't have time for joking around. What are you doing here? Save me. Is that what you were trying to accomplish by riding in that swoop race? Well, as far as rescues go, this is a pretty poor example. In case you hadn't
noticed,
I managed to free myself from that neural restraint collar without your help. In fact, it's more accurate to say that I saved you. Brezhig and his Vulkas would have left you for dead if I hadn't stepped into that fight. You're lucky I was here to get you out of this mess. I may have been a prisoner, but a Jedi is never helpless. Maybe you've heard of a little thing called the Force? But I suppose I shouldn't be too hard on you. You did try to save me, after all, even if it didn't go quite as planned. So let's get down to business. We're not out of danger yet. If I'm going to figure out a way for us to get off this planet, I need to know what kind of resources we can draw on. First, are we the only two survivors left from the Ender's Fire? The Republic, for one. I was a fleet commander, remember? But I don't want you getting all worked up over nothing. So tell me, do you have a plan to get off? Karth Unassi is alive. Finally, some good news. Karth is one of the Republic's best soldiers. He's proved himself a hero a dozen times over. And he sent you here to save me. Maybe I misjudged you. Karth wouldn't have sent you if he wasn't confident in your abilities. Forgive me. Despite my Jedi training, I still tend to act a bit rashly sometimes. Please take me to Karth right away. Between the three of us, I'm sure we can figure out some way to get off this planet before the Sith realize we're here.
Ooh, she's a yellow saber.
You cannot win, Revan.
Oh, she didn't actually kill him. The explosion did.
Bastila, you're alive! Finally, things are looking up. Now I just need to figure out a way to get off this planet.
You mean you don't have a plan to get off Taurus yet? What have you been doing all this time? My attitude. It strikes me that you are the one in sore need of an attitude adjustment. I happen to be in charge of this mission, if you'll recall.
I know you're new at this, Bastila, but a leader doesn't berate her troops just because things aren't going as planned. Don't let your ego get in the way of the real issues here.
That highly strikes me as an appropriate way of addressing your commander, Karth. I am a member of the Jedi Order, and this is my mission. Don't forget that. My battle meditation ability has helped the Republic many times in this war, and it will serve us well here, I'm sure.
Your talents might win us a few battles, but that doesn't make you a good leader. A good leader would at least listen to the advice of those who have seen more combat than she ever will.
Yeah.
You know, I had my doubts about this mission, but I figured the Jedi Council wouldn't put you in charge if you weren't prepared. Here you are, acting like a spoiled child.
I see. It's true that I don't have much military experience. Perhaps I should not be so quick to judge. Very well, Karth. What do you suggest we do?
First off, we can't get hung up on who's in charge. We all need to work together if we want to get off this rock. The answer is out there. We just have to find it.
Well said, Karth. And the sooner we start looking, the better. I've already been a prisoner of the Vulkas, and I don't plan on being captured by the Sith. I think we'll need some help getting off Terrace. Maybe if we ask around, one of the locals can help us out. We should probably start by asking around in the cantinas. Is something wrong? You seem as if something's troubling you. A vision? A vision of what? This is a bit strange. Such visions are often a sign of force sensitivity. I'm not sure. It may be that you have some connection to the Force. It would not be unheard of. When we first met, your natural talent may have fed off my own Force abilities. It is possible that in the excitement of the battle's aftermath, the Force allowed you to witness one of my more intense memories. The Force is complicated. Even I, with all my training, cannot fully understand it yet. This is a matter best left to the wise masters of the Jedi Council. Once we escape Terrace, we can seek the guidance of the Council if you wish.
Yeah.
They will understand the significance of your vision, if there is any. However, I think it would be best if we all stayed focused on the task at hand right now. We can't afford any distractions. We need to find a way off Terrace. How can I help? I would like to know what happened after you crashed on Taris. I'm curious as to what you and Karth were doing before we all joined forces. I managed to free myself, as I recall. In fact, if I hadn't been there, Brezhik and his thugs might have killed you in that fight. It's probably more accurate to say that I rescued you. I'll admit that I probably wouldn't have been able to free myself if not for the brawl after the swoop race. I guess I should thank you for that, at least. Actually, your presence at the swoop track is what I'm curious about. It couldn't have been an easy task to find me there, yet somehow you managed. You also avoided detection by the Sith, discovered I was a Vulcan prisoner, gained sponsorship for the race, and became the Taurus swoop champion. It's quite a resume. Yes, I can see you do not lack in ability, although modesty is another matter. When you were chosen to join this mission, I doubt any of us expected this much from you. A Jedi could have done such things, of course.
I could do much more.
The Force is in all of us, though for most people it's barely a measurable whisper. There are some individuals outside the Jedi Order that we consider Force-sensitive. It's obvious to me that the Force has been working through you. There is no other explanation for your great success. Though I'm not certain what to make of this discovery. Perhaps if you weren't... Well, if you were younger, the Jedi might take you for training. But as it is... I'm sorry. I've overstepped my authority. I'm speaking of things that are best left to the Jedi Council. For now, let's just accept the fact that you're gifted.
Hopefully, I'm gifted.
Between your abilities, my Jedi training, and the skills of our companions, we can find a way off this planet.
Hey there, what can I do for you? I was a little snappish when we last talked. I'm sorry about that. I get a little tired. No, I want to tell you. Zalbar's a great listener, but it might be nice to talk about this with someone who doesn't reply. I never knew my parents. My brother always looked out for me. He's the one who brought me here to Taurus. I was just a kid, only 5. But I remember the trip, if you could call it that. We were stuffed inside a packing crate in a Starfighter's cargo hold with just enough food and water to make the trip. Not exactly first class, you know? I don't know the whole story. I was pretty young. But my brother owed a lot of money. Might even have been a few arrest warrants out for him, I don't know. The only way to get off the planet was to smuggle ourselves out. I mean, I don't want to make it sound like we were criminals. Well, maybe my brother was. See, this is why I don't like to talk about it. It makes Griff sound worse than he really was. My brother had his problems, but he always looked out for me. He gambled and drank, and... he was always borrowing money for his latest get-rich-quick scheme. But he had a good heart, you know? He taught me how to survive. Showed me how to slice into a computer security system. How to get inside a locked building without the entrance codes. And how to spot a wealthy mark for a quick shell game. Yeah, Griff did right by me. I really miss him since he left. I keep hoping he'll come back someday. He promised me he would. Why do you gotta go putting my brother down like that? That's just mean. Besides, it wasn't his idea to leave. He fell in with a bad crowd. It's all Lena's fault. She's the one who took him from me. Just batted those long lashes at him and off he went. I don't want to talk about Griff and Lena. Just the thought of that space tramp makes my blood boil. Subject's closed as far as I'm concerned. If I'm gonna be any help to you, I can't be worrying about my brother running off with some intergalactic skank. So is there something else you need?
Ooh.
Okay.
Ta bist yu bong konki pangpa. Ching pala chiska muli. Rundi hadonga ku hunga bi. Wana ku. Tong hai tuam jiji yu malith pa ang inkotu. Tolba da bong kwal. Shag jikin lor chawa ta uma. Kava volpa.
Yeah?
Sure.
Yes?
Hey, Bastila. You ever use the Force just for fun? You know, a little jolt to the Force to trip up some jerk who's ticking you off?
I would never use the Force for such petty and trivial revenge. The mere thought of it's preposterous.
Aw, come on. There's gotta be times when you've thought about it. Don't be so stuck up. You can tell me.
I am not stuck up. I merely have the years of training to give me the wisdom and understanding to see how childish such an act would be.
Childish? Is that a crack about my age? You ain't much older than me, Miss High and Mighty. Just because you're some Jedi doesn't mean you can be a prissy little... What the... Hey, that wasn't funny.
I have no idea what you're talking about, Mission. Come now, we have to get going. Please, do try to be less clumsy in the future.
Ooh.
Remember, if you get your hands on that Rakgul serum, take it to Zax in the Lower City Bounty Office. He works for Davik. And...
This elevator is off limits. It's obvious from the way you're... Well, why didn't you say? Just be careful.
I saw you in the swoop race. Very impressive. You seem like you know how to get results. That's just the kind of person I'm looking for. My name's Candorous Ordo. I work for Davik Kang in the Exchange. The hours aren't great, but they promised me a fortune to work for them, and I had nothing better to do. Mandalorian mercs like me are in high demand. But lately, Davik hasn't been paying me what he promised. I don't like getting cheated. So I figure it's time for me to break the Sith quarantine and get off this backwater planet. I've got a plan to escape, Taris, but I can't do it alone. I need someone I know can get the job done to help me. That's where you come in.
You don't need to ally yourself with this person. We should move on while we can.
I ain't talking to you. I'm talking with your friend, aren't I? I saw you win that swoop race and started thinking. Anyone crazy enough to race like that is probably crazy enough to break into the Sith military base. I need someone to steal the Sith launch codes from the base. Without those codes, any ship leaving the atmosphere will be disintegrated by the Sith fleet's automated defense guns. Here's the deal. You bring me those launch codes, and I can provide the vehicle to get us off the planet. Davik's flagship, the Ebon Hawk. Not yet. First, you bring me the launch codes. Then I'll tell you the rest of my plan. Getting in won't be easy. The Sith base is protected by an encrypted security system. It would take a top-of-the-line astromech droid to slice through it. Lucky for you, I know just the place to get a droid like that. Davik was having one custom built by Janice Nahl. Just tell her Candoris sent you and she'll sell you the droid. Then you can use it to get the launch codes from the Sith base. Davik paid for the droid, but I'm the guy he put in charge of the mission. He won't care how I come up with those codes. Normally I'd do this myself, but everyone knows who I work for. If I broke into the Sith base, they'd send an army down on Davik's estate to get those codes back. That's why I need you.
I don't sense any deception from him, which is surprising. This may be exactly what we need.
Sooner or later, you'll figure this out. Either we work together or we both stay stuck here on Taurus. Come back and speak to me again when you've come to your senses.
How can I help? The surface of Taurus is covered with an urban skyscraper. Beyond that, there is...
I figured you'd be back. But we've got a small... If you want me to help...
I'm here.
Yeah?
What? Yes?
Time to get me a droid.
Punky, Jishawa anibun ka sha.
Mokao danya foki, chachiska to punta ka kaspaka.
Atawamamuliri, Kin Kun Chopeshwa, No Bamule Raji, Jone Yuturi Yanchi.
Tokyo Drift. Sure, I'll auto level you, bro. Ooh, I'm looking mad angry. Collect the kill this bounty and win the fighting circle before I go into the Sith base. God, you're always so slow.
I'm here.
What?
What are you doing, dude?
Sure.
Okay, are we all set? Are we all good? Can you follow me now?
Ladies, he's a legend in the sport, a 20-year veteran who still knows how to show the young kid.
This guy's easy now.
Maybe even as good as Bendak in his prime. There's no shame in losing to you. But first, it was just Twitch I couldn't handle. Now it's you and Twitch. Pretty soon, there'll be another young hotshot clawing past me in the rankings. This game's been good to me, but my time is done. I need to get away from the duel rings for a while, think things over. Goodbye, stranger.
Ladies and gentlemen, hold on to your seats and stay back from the edges of the ring. He's wild, he's unpredictable, he's borderline psychotic, and he's the best damn duelist in the game today. Give it up for Twitch and this.
Easy.
It's over! The fight Twitch's reign of terror is over, ladies and gentlemen! We have a new champion, the Mysterious Stranger!
Such a dumb nickname.
I've been watching you in the dueling ring. Not bad for an amateur. I'm tempted to come out of retirement and show you what it's like to do battle against a real champion, but I only fight in death matches. And not too many people are willing to step into the ring knowing they won't ever come out. How about you, stranger? You think you got what it takes? So you're the one doing Zax's dirty work. Well, I've got some bad news for you, little... This cantina is wired with a top-level security grid. You pull a weapon on me and the auto-fire turrets will fry you before you can even pull the... Why would I ever want to leave here? I've got food and drink, but if you're set on collecting that bounty, I'll make you a deal. I kind of missed the fight game. My hand is itching for the feel of a blaster in my grip. I've seen you in the duel ring. You're just good enough to spark my interest, so I'll agree to fit. Finally, fresh meat. Azure will set it up. Go talk to him. It will take some time to arrange, so no point sticking around here until then. I'll be back when it's time for you to die.
Search at Oma Toma. Calavoy Pamuji.